Okay, so today we are going to do an unboxing of the Ghost Scribbler Writers subscription box. This is actually my last of these boxes for the next 3 months. If you guys have been around for a while and you've watched most of these unboxings, you would know that I haven't actually been really using the advice that has been sent in the boxes. So I'm giving myself 3 months to try and catch up on some of that advice and then reevaluate whether or not it's actually going to be helpful for me going forward, whether I keep the subscription box or not. So I happen to think the subscription box is fantastic. They do include advice on both the art of writing and also some techniques and ideas on entering the publishing industry, querying, contacting publishers, getting agents, you know, all of that sort of thing that goes along with publishing. You also get some cute little things, sometimes a snack, and you also get a book. But for me personally, I just felt that there wasn't much point in getting all of this stuff that I wasn't really using. So like I said, I'm putting it on hold. It's not to say that if you are interested in subscribing, you shouldn't do so, because I do think the box is fantastic. It just, yeah, that's just where I personally have sort of fallen when it comes to this particular subscription box. So like I said, that is Ghost Scribbler's Writer's subscription box. I'm not affiliated with them. This is not sponsored. I don't get anything from them or anything off of the subscription or anything like that. So just so you know that. The details of how you can subscribe is in the description below. However, so if you want to go ahead and do that, then that's where to get the information. We're doing an unboxing, but we're also doing a haul, because I've actually hauled quite a few books. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 books as well to show you. Kind of feel like I might be developing a little bit of a book buying problem. It's not to say that I haven't always enjoyed buying books, as you know I have, but yeah, I might need to reevaluate that as well. Not sure about putting myself on book buying bans or anything like that, because I don't know how successful that would be, to be completely honest, but yeah, I think I need to reevaluate. But anyway, for today, we're going to first of all do the box unboxing and then the haul. I'm just going to turn the camera angle around so that you can see me do the unboxing, but first let's do our thumbnail so you can see me actually unbox. I have cut it open to make it easier, but I haven't unboxed it yet, so let's do that. Okay, so I'm gonna put the box over here and reposition you, and let's go. So the first thing, as usual, is a little postcard with all the info on the writer's subscription, the writing contest. Write down your number one writing goal for 2021 and how you'll achieve it. All right, so let's get rid of all of the squiggles. Oh, something made out of something canvassy. What is that? Oh, it's a tote. Oh, that's cool. It's got still some squiggles attached to it. It says, between the pages of a book is a lovely place to be. And then it's got a picture of a book with a mountain. Oh, that's gorgeous. And it's a really nice sturdy canvas as well, so that will come in handy. All right. Ooh. And then we have, a nice fountain pen. That's nice. That's pretty cool. I tend to do most of my writing just directly onto the computer, but that's still very cool. ZZ's Mixies Dried Fruit. Raisins, golden raisins, pineapple, cranberries, and apples. Yum. I might even eat this afternoon. So it sounds delicious. Okay, and then we have the writing passport. So this is the author of the book writing some advice on writing, and this is to do with cliffhangers. Writing cliffhangers at the end of books, that is very cool. And then we have the publishing process inside look. So this is about pitching your stories. Okay, that's cool. So again, I think this is probably incredibly helpful, but I do think that I need to properly, you know, go through and actually try to figure out doing this. So that's that there. And then finally we have the book, which is Spellbreaker by Charlie N. Holmberg. That's a cool cover. All right, I shall read the blurb to you. The often Let me start again. The orphaned Elsie Camden learned as a girl that there were two kinds of wizards in the world. Those who pay for the power to cast spells, and those, like her, born with the ability to break them. But as an unlicensed magic user, her gift is a crime. Commissioned by an underground group known as the Cowls, Elise uses her spellbreaking to push back against aristocrats and help the common man. She always did love the tale of Robin Hood. Elite magic user, Bacchus Kelsey, is one elusive spell away from his mastership when he catches Elsie breaking an enchantment. To protect her secret, Elsie strikes a bargain. She'll help Bacchus fix unruly spells around his estate if he doesn't turn her in. Working together, Elsie's trust in and fondness for the handsome stranger grows. So does her trepidation about the rise in the murders of wizards and the theft of the spellbooks their bodies leave behind. For a rogue spellbreaker like Elsie, there's so much to learn about her powers, her family, the intriguing Bacchus, and the untold dangers of shadowing every step of a journey she's destined to complete. But will she uncover the mystery before it's too late to save everything she loves? Now, I know that I do actually say that all the books sound great, and they do, but this one actually sounds right up my alley. I love fabulism, set in the real world but full of magic kind of book. I love a alternative world, alternative London, which I think is what that's going to be. And I love a historical fiction, which I think is also what it's going to be. So it does sound fantastic. So as we are doing a haul as well as an unboxing, I will pop it just there. Sorry, and then also I have the author signature. Pop that just, well, I might actually pop it straight into the book because it's a sticker. There we are. All right, and as we are doing a haul as well as an unboxing, I'm going to swing you around there so that I can show you the books that I bought. So let's start with the book that I bought because I drove past a bookstore and saw it in the window and I knew that I really wanted it. So I bought The Other Bennett Sister by Janice Hadlow. So this is actually a retelling of Pride and Prejudice from Mary Bennett's perspective. Mary Bennett was the middle sister, and in Pride and Prejudice she really isn't in the story very much except that she's kind of a laughingstock. So this is from her perspective, and yeah, it sounds like it's really interesting. I've heard that it's quite a good book. It's a lot thicker than I was anticipating. It's actually 655 pages long, so it's bigger than I thought it was, but that's okay. I don't mind a big book. Yeah, anyway, that one there. Just pop it on top. Then you saw some of the books that I bought when I was doing the vlog. So I decided randomly that I just felt like going to the bookstore, so I did. I wanted to get the second Frostheart, so Frostheart Escape from Aurora, which is by Jamie Littler. So that was the reason I went to the bookstore, because I knew this had come out relatively recently and I really enjoyed the first one, so I wanted to buy the second one. Frostheart is a middle grade. It is a fantasy. It's set in a sort of polar landscape, so it's a polar fantasy, and it is about a young boy, Ash, who is thought to be part of a sort of subset of people who are song weavers, which is something that is considered a bad thing. And so he has kind of been passed from guardian to guardian, and then he's finally got his Yeti guardian, and they end up going on the Frostheart, which is a sleigh, and they become pathfinders, which is what the people who run the sleighs are. Really fun, well-written, fantastic fantasy. So I bought that one. And as you probably know, I bought a while ago from a secondhand bookstore part one of The Way of Kings. When I bought it, I actually didn't realize somehow that I had bought part one. I thought, because the book has been published as a full book, which is like over 1,000 pages long. And then it's also been published in part one and part two. And I didn't realize that I'd grabbed part one of it. Anyway, so I thought, let's see what I can find in the bookstore. So I grabbed part two of Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson. This is the first book, or this is part two of the first book of the Stormlight Archives. It is a fantasy series. That's pretty much all I know about it, which is actually fine. I have heard enough praise for Brandon Sanderson that I am very excited to read his books. So this one is 530 pages long, and the other one I think was 540 pages long. So yeah, all up it's over 1,000 pages long. So I'm actually kind of glad that I now have the smaller books, because it'll be a lot easier to hold. And then also in that trip, I brought Solutions and Other Problems by Allie Brosch. Now, Allie Brosch used to be a web comic writer. Yes, she was doing a web comic called Hyperbole and a Half, which I really thought was hilarious. I was actually introduced to it by a lecturer at university when I was doing my teaching degree, so I was quite interested in the web comic itself. Then she put together a book of the webcomic Hyperbole and a Half, and then she kind of disappeared for quite a while, and now she's come out with Solutions and Other Problems. I have heard that it is explains quite a lot of what was going on for her during her sort of time away. She lives with quite substantial depression and anxiety and other mental health issues, so I think there's quite a lot to do with her situation in this book as well. It is a graphic novel. I'm not a huge graphic novel reader, but I did love this webcomic, so I'm anticipating absolutely loving this one. Actually quite a heavy book. All right, now when I was in that bookstore, I did see the next book that I have here to show you, but for some reason I didn't buy it. I don't know why. So then I went to the supermarket a couple of days later, and I just decided maybe I should pop into the bookstore, because actually I really do want that book. Totally different bookstore. Anyway, so that book is The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by Victoria Schwab. This will be my first ever Victoria Schwab. I have heard that this book is amazing. I have heard maybe one or two people who weren't as interested in it as the majority of people on BookTube, but most people that I have heard talk about this book have absolutely raved about how amazing it is. Like I said, I've never read any Victoria Schwab, or V.E. Schwab, as she is when she writes these sorts of books. I'm not sure what the difference is, but anyway, she's either Victoria Schwab or V.E. Schwab, depending, I think, on maybe it's adult versus young adult, I don't know. But anyway, in this one it's V.E. Schwab. I'm pretty sure this is adult fantasy, and it's about a woman called Addie LaRue back in the 1400s, I think. She is supposed to, she's had a marriage arranged for her, but she doesn't want to marry the person she's supposed to marry. So basically a kind of demon approaches her, and she makes a deal with the demon whereby she doesn't have to marry this person, and in fact she will become immortal, she will live forever. But the payoff is that anytime anyone interacts with her, they don't immediately forget her. Then one day, I think actually in present day, someone actually remembers her. So it's that story. I don't really know much else. Like, that's the kind of blurb and the kind of general storyline that I've heard. So I don't really know much else about it. But like I said, I've heard that it's just amazing. I'm very intrigued to read it, very keen to read it. So by now you would have all seen my Present City first time reading Sarah J. Maas vlog. Possibly when I read this one, I might vlog that as well. We'll see. Comment below and let me know if you'd like to watch a vlog of me reading V.E. Schwab for the first time. Anyhow, then same trip to the bookstore en route to the supermarket. That's what I'm talking about, that sort of thing. It's okay to go specifically shopping in a bookstore, but possibly when I'm just popping down the road to get bread, I shouldn't also pop into the bookstore. Anyhow, I did, and I also got The Priory of the Orange Tree by Samantha Shannon. So most of you probably know that I read this book earlier last year in 2020 and absolutely loved it. It was my favourite book of 2020, but I didn't have a copy of my own because I borrowed it off a colleague. So now I do have a copy of my own. I definitely know that I would like to at some point reread this book. So this is quite a small version. I don't know whether this is a mass market paperback or not, but it's still pretty long, 804 pages long, so they've just shrunk it down, I guess. But the other one did have huge margins, whereas this is a bit more normal, so I guess that's how that's worked. I also love the cover of that one. I also love the cover of Addie LaRue. Okay, so then just yesterday, in fact, my friend Michelle, who I've mentioned many times on this channel, who has actually appeared on this channel a few times, and I decided to spend the day hanging out, or the afternoon hanging out, and we decided that of course we were going to go to the bookstore together because that's what we do. So I managed to actually only buy three books that time, but what I got was Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. So again, as you would have seen in my Crescent City vlog, I am now a very big fan of Sarah J. Maas. I really want to read some more of her work. My friend Alison the other day was describing it as kind of your more sort of typical high fantasy, Lord of the Rings, elves and fairies and orcs and those sorts of things, but I believe that it's about an assassin whose name I am not 100% sure. Yes, anyway, I've heard that he's an assassin, and it's about hurt, basically. So, yeah, I'm really excited to delve into some more Sarah J. Maas. Kind of being stuck here now, but I've only got two more books to go. And then I bought Normal People by Sally Rooney. This is a book that I've actually seen at that bookstore the last few times that I went there, and I didn't get it. But finally, I decided that I would because I am intrigued to read it. This is a book that is a little bit divisive, I think. A lot of people on BookTube have really liked it, but then again, a lot of people on BookTube have not liked it. But I'm intrigued to see what I think of it as well. From what I know of it, it is a kind of contemporary literary fiction style book. Don't really know much else about it. It says, Normal People is a mute. It's a story of mutual fascination, friendship, and love. I'm intrigued to see what I think. And then my final book that I got is, in terms of cover and prettiness, is my favourite of all of these. Look at that. It's just so pretty. So this is The Betrayals by Bridget Collins. In 2019, I read The Binding by Bridget Collins, and I really, really enjoyed it. It's very odd, and I think it's one of those books that you either like or you don't like. So I've heard very mixed reviews about it on BookTube, but I personally thought it was just incredible, and I'm really excited to read The Betrayals as well because, yeah, I really enjoyed that book, and I want to see if I continue to enjoy her work. Hello! It has been a few days since I did the unboxing of the Go Scribbler, and I actually have another package that I would like to unbox for you. I do actually know what this is, but I thought you guys might be keen to see. This is from Owl Crate. I have already undone it, but I haven't opened it. You guys probably know I don't actually get Owl Crate, the subscription box, but I do keep an eye on all of the videos that you guys make when you get them, and some of the stuff that I like I do order. So we have an Owl Crate box with a little thank you for shopping, which I think is very cute. First thing that we have is actually two of the same. So we have two of these reading planners. So I got last year's reading planner and I've really enjoyed using it. And also it's really pretty. So I got two this year. One is for myself and one is for my friend Michelle. Because actually not long before I was able to order this, she messaged me and said, do you know of any reading planners or anything like that? And I said, yes, I know Owl Crate do one. And I ordered it last year and I'm going to order this year's. Do you want me to let you know when it becomes available to order individually? And she said yes, but I sneakily bought her one. So I'll just show you through some of it. I love this. It's a thing where you can put in your favorite books. They've changed it slightly from last year. It's actually a little bit bigger somehow, and it's the same size planner, so I'm not sure. We have a book wish list and a monthly TBR. We have our weekly planner with the to-do list. At the back of each month is a book review. There's a notes section, favourite quotes, monthly wrap-up. So it's all the sort of stuff that you need to do your monthly wrap-up, and you're notified, you're keeping track of your books and reading and everything. So there is also another thing in here. There's actually two, again, it's two of the same. This time I bought one lot for myself and one lot for my parents because I know they'd really like this as well. So I'll just show you the envelopes, but I'll only show you what's up in one packet. And it is the little postcards of all of the beautiful flora from The Lord of the Rings. So most of these plants actually have special meaning in the book. So we have Eleanor, which is the beautiful little flower that grows in Lothlorien and that Sam calls his daughter because it's a beautiful little flower and he couldn't think of what to call her. And Frodo says, well, it's a flower. Flower names are traditional. Why don't you go with Eleanor from Lorien? And then we have a Nifredel. I don't actually know what the significance of that is, so I might have to look up the appendixes because I think that it might not be in the main section of the story. And we have Athelas, or King's Foil as it's commonly called, and that is actually sort of viewed as a weed, but it's got ancient traditions to do with Numenor, which is the old line of people, which is where Aragorn is from. So there's this whole rhyme that says that when the king comes back, he will use this and it will cure people. And that's what happens in the books. And then we have Semelmine, which again, I'm not sure what the significance is, but it's a flower from Rohan. And then we have the Malorn, or branch of the Malorn tree. And this is one of the biggest beautiful trees in Lorien, so they have beautiful silver trunks and then beautiful golden leaves. And Sam is given a seed from the Malorn tree, which he then plants in the putty field
when they return to the Shire and realise that the Shire has been overrun, so, and that tree is chopped down, so he plants the melon tree there. Yeah, so I think these are beautiful, and I'm a big fan of Lord of the Rings. I've grown up with many Lord of the Rings things. I have Lord of the Rings. I have a poster just up here, which you can't see, but it is from a tour that I did in New Zealand, where I went around Wellington and looked at all the sites where they filmed what they filmed of the movie in Wellington or around Wellington. And then just on the other side of this door is a poster of the Lord of the Rings. It's the characters, main characters from Lord of the Rings, and some of the other sort of important points that I've actually had since I was like 16 or maybe even younger, that my parents, I think I bought myself, but then my parents had framed for me. Big Lord of the Rings fan, and I just thought these were beautiful when I saw different people opening them, so I wanted to get them, and I knew Mum and Dad would really like them. So yeah, that actually does conclude my unboxing and haul for the first bit of this year. So there you go. Thank you all so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you have anything you'd like to say about what I bought, what I received, my decision to do with the Go Scribbler box, then please comment below and let me know. I'd love to chat with you about all of these things. And if you hung out for this long and you want to leave me an emoji, then please leave me a little box. That'd be lovely too. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Like I said, I really do hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next time.